It's a case of sticker shock at the pump. Gas prices have gone up for the 24th day in a row now, and there are no signs of backing down. So here's what prices look like right now in California. The average for a gallon of regular is $4.34, mid-grade $4.44, premium $4.54. Again, those are averages. But what's driving the price up? I'm joined now by energy expert Lou Ann Hammond from Driving the Nation. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We were talking a little bit in the commercial break. There's not one specific factor for why gas prices are going up. That's what you say.
We just have a lot more cars on the road. It used to be that I could say supply and demand for the United States. But now we have emerging countries like China and India. There are over 1 billion cars on the road, according to Ward's Auto. So you still have about 88 million barrels a day of oil that we're using, but we want now to share that with many different countries. I talked to a friend from Korea last night that works for Kia. Their price of gasoline has gone up 72 cents a gallon in the last month.
And it seems like it's been this last month that we've seen this high cost, because it was only 30 days ago when I believe we were spending about 50, 60 cents less. Are speculators still a big part of this? Are they the ones saying, well, you know, optimism seems to be good right now with the U.S. economy. Let's hike up the prices. People will pay for it.
There are a lot of things in play. I remember a couple of years ago, right before the Chinese Olympics, they were saying the same thing. And yet what really happened was China took all their coal offline, brought in a bunch of diesel to clean up their air so the Olympic air would be much cleaner. So always world problems right now instead of little problems. The biggest problem is the International Transport Forum last year said that 2.5 billion cars will be on the roads by 2050. And that's going to be a lot more gasoline that we need to find, or the prices will really go up.
Well, it certainly is a political issue as well, as we've seen around the world. Let's talk about who needs to use premium. If you have a certain kind of car, they put recommendations that you should use the highest octane. Who needs to use it?
Well, those cars are the ones that are the high performance cars, or they can be the really small displacement engines that have turbocharging, twin turbocharging. So either one of those, you can use regular gasoline because they have NOx sensors in there and there won't be those problems that they used to have in the earlier years of cars. Mm-hmm. But if you want high performance, you're going to need that high gasoline.
It's not going to improve your mileage any if you use premium gas.
No.
Okay.
No. Especially if you're going really fast.
It might just be easier on your engine. Are there any really good ways to save money on gas right now besides using public transit?
You know, people really laughed at President Obama when he said, make sure your tires are filled properly. But that really is one of the easiest things to do. And a couple other things are, you know, making sure that you have clean oil. Synthetic oil is really good. And in the air filter, if your air filter gets dirty, that's going to hurt you as well. So just the basic duties of cleaning your engine.
Let's talk about some of the things that people are saying on Facebook. We have this posted on our website right now, facebook.com/KCRA3. And Barbara says, it was over $100 to fill up the tank today, or the truck. I don't care how nice the weekend is. I'm staying home. And no, we can't buy a smaller car. We need to truck to work. Don says, road trips out to dinner, stimulating the economy, out of the question. Only the very necessary. It seems as though this goes in cycles. Do you think, based on your experience, that the American people will get any type of a break this year, or will we continue to see gas prices near $5 a gallon?
It's going to be real interesting for the next couple of months right before Memorial Day. That's when we always see that sort of spike. Mm-hmm. Right now, they're producing as much gas as they can. But once again, it's not because we don't have the supply. It's because the entire world is using gasoline.
Well, we'll see what happens nearing the presidential elections, too. That may play a part. Thank you so much, Ms. Hammond. We appreciate you joining us.